this chessboard. Hello, hi, and namaste. Welcome back to another Sunday. So tell me, how many of y'all have come to Bombay Urf Mumbai? Obviously, I cannot see y'all guys through the screen, but I'm assuming a lot of y'all have. You know what I have noted? Besides from any work or business, people from Goa come to Mumbai either for shopping, vacation, function, doctor's appointment, and visa. Oh wait, and now to meet Divine's mom, because chal Bombay tujhe maa se milata hun, makana ka go. Okay, don't unsubscribe. You know, people who have big Israel Forza types family spread across the world. So obviously someone from that lot also has to be a Bombay rep, right? If not the family, then maybe some family friend or some random friend that you met is from Bombay, but you will have someone from Bombay. See, now I go to Goa for my vacations, but when I was in Goa, I used to come to Mumbai for my vacation. And now when I tell these things to my friends in Bombay, they go like, kya chuhe re, tu Mumbai aati thi vacation manane ke liye? मुंबई में वेकेशन एटलीस्ट लोनावला तो जाती, गोवा की है, कितनी लकी है रे तू।
मालूम है तेरे बाप को, मत सिखा, चल।
See, now we either say it's Bombay or Mumbai, okay? Especially the Catholics, they tend to say Bombay. I don't know how to explain that to you. You know, it's funny, let me tell you why. When I go to Goa, I get called Bombay Kan, Mumbai Kan, Bombay Kan, okay? And when I come back to Bombay, I get called the Goan Pao, the Goinchi Mana, Tumka Jai Pana, I don't know what else. Kidhar jaun main mar jaun, mere koi feelings nahi hai. Tumhari feelings tumhari, Twadda Goinkar, Goinkar, Sadda Goinkar, Bombay Kan. So in today's video, I'm going to talk a little about what happens when a Goinkar comes to Bombay. Again, this video is focused on people who live in Goa and not the Goans from Bombay. I hope you get that. Okay, I've blabbered a lot now, but without any much blabbering, let's just get started. Traveling and places. Now, of course, everybody travels to another place for a reason, but the most common reason that I hear when I ask people, they either tell me they are coming to shop, because people are under this impression, right, that things over here are cheaper. It's true. Especially when it comes to clothes, it's really cheap. All them girls come here and spend a bomb. Then people come for vacations, you know, to stay with their cousins who are from Bombay. People come here for doctor's appointments. People come here for someone's function. And I think lately the most common reason that I hear is visa. Hey, can you hear that? That's the making of the Portuguese passport. Some of the people who come for the visa thing and they do not like Bombay, they just come for like one day. They'll come in the morning and they'll go back in the evening because they just cannot stay in Bombay for some reason. So whenever I'm in Goa and I ask them, have you all ever been to Bombay? And I can literally tell you the places I expect them to see. Mostly they're going to talk about Metro, Church Gate, Cross Maidan, Fashion Street, then the clubs that they stayed in there. Sometimes it's the Crawford Market, Nariman Point, Dobi Talab, and not forgetting Marine Drive. And to be very honest, I don't blame them because they only roam in that area. There is nothing happening in where I live except for the traffic. The next thing is comparison and complaints. See, you cannot compare Goa with Bombay because both of them have their own advantages and both of them are good in their own way. But still, for the sake of it, if you ask me being me, I'd say the difference is the rickshaws. Hold up, let me explain. My younger cousin brother who's in Goa, I asked him once why he wants to come to Bombay and he's like, I want to go for a rickshaw ride. But this was there Naimun. I don't know if you have noticed this, but the rickshaws in Goa have a door. Even that one time when my mom's friend came to Bombay and she saw the rickshaws and she was like, ek der nahi. Come on, if you're expecting me to state differences like the transportation system, the pollution, the lifestyle of the people, no, rickshaws are the main difference. Mumbai is known for dreams, opportunities, huge, big buildings and fast life, whereas Goa is still known for its beauty, nature, beaches and vacation. And nothing can change that, not even if someone made a stupid reel talking crap about Goa. Now when it comes to complaints, I relate to this, you know why? Because when I should take the bus to come to Bombay, I used to know I have entered Bombay with this weird headache giving smell. It's going to destroy your nostrils, okay? And you won't be able to take it. Not even the mask can save your nostrils. The crowded trains and buses, okay? Now if in Goa, if you take a bus and run behind it, probably the bus would wait for you. Over here, even if you're hanging through the bus, it won't wait for you till it reaches the stop. Once my friend came to Mumbai and she was so excited, you know, to see the local trains. I took her there once and I think it's been 4 years she has not come back to Bombay. Because I think the last time she came, she probably got a little more stamped, pushed, squeezed in the train, I think so. the traffic and how badly they miss their personal vehicles. The rickshawalas and pilots in Goa and the rickshawalas in Bombay are way different. The rickshawalas here, they reject you more than you've ever been rejected for a rishta. Soy rik. Ah, boy, ni hui ospa che. Yo, ko paayda. Rickshaw inga lai lo. Paayin chi datle. Bare bare. Chal, don chi di chal yo.
Main lokand wala chaloge. Andheri chaloge. Bandra chaloge, bhaiya. भैया सेंटा क्रूज नहीं 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 ईस्ट कलीना में
Number 3 is getting scammed. Now it's pretty obvious if you're a tourist anywhere in the world, you are bound to get scammed. Whoever it may be, my friends, my family or my relatives that plan to come here, I tell them, do not, even in the slightest form, let the other person know that you are from Goa, especially when you're traveling. So once this friend of mine, he came from Goa to Bombay, okay? And he had to reach this hotel which was just 10 minutes away. And in the rickshaw, he gave out, hey, main Goa se hoon and all that. And he was taken on a 45-minute journey when this hotel was only 10 minutes away. So the only solution here is to not give that out that you're from Goa. And secondly, try to speak in Hindi, even if it's bad. I don't really see the point here of you not getting scammed because you're speaking Hindi. But still. Hey, tere ko main pagal dis hota hai. Bo raha, mark photo deta hai tinga. Maal ki riyad. Ye Google Maps right road dikata hai. Tum right maro. Maro re right. Main trai na kahe tu geli. Meter kyun ne gunaya hai? Gunaya. Aata hai begin. Bo raha mamu mark photo deta. Okay, let us talk about this small world concept. Let me explain what I mean by that. When you meet someone who happens to be a mutual friend, you know they say small world. I mean some or the other cousin's relative of someone else's cousin's relative is your cousin. You would be lying to me, my friend, if you tell me you haven't met someone new that happens to know someone that you know. Oh, that one is my family friend. Oh, that family friend is your friend. He's my friend too. It's a discovery. I know I would have to do a proper research if I ever find a guy who's Goan to not be my far away relative. And that is all I had for you guys today. I hope you all enjoyed the video. And if you did, please hit the like button. Share this video with all your friends that would relate to this video. Comment down below and let me know if you've ever been to Bombay and had any of these experiences. And if you like my videos, please hit that subscribe button. Along with that, hit the bell icon so you do not miss any of my videos. Until then, Mog and peace. See you next Sunday.